Your name's Sandra Edwards?
Who?
Sandra Edwards.
No, it's not me. It should say Janine Scott, immoral earnings in 3 weeks. I'll tell you what, if this chick got less than 3 weeks, I'll be her if you like.
Get on the line. These papers correct?
As far as I know.
Then someone's made a mistake. Look, I better check at the City Watch House. They'll be able to tell me.
Better go and get Mr. Fletcher.
He's trouble. He looks like the boss.
Boss?
All right, tell me the story. All right, Edwards, Peterson, on your feet.
Did I hear you say I was meant to go to Barnhurst? They did get things mixed up, didn't they? But don't worry. I'll catch a taxi if you like.
You stay right where you were.
They'll soon work it out. You keep going, you'll get into trouble.
Yeah, well, I suppose I've had my fun. Mr. Fletcher, isn't it?
That's right.
I suppose I'd better own up.
I thought so. I don't care who you think you are, Edwards. In here, you're just another prisoner. I'm here to make sure that you understand that. All right?
Yes, Mr. Fletcher.
Good. Carry on, please, Miss Conway.
Get on that line.
All right. Joke's over. Rack off.
Hey, come on, Judy. This isn't worth fighting over. Let's forget it. Shake on it?
Okay. I'll play the game, but don't expect me to put up with this kind of stupid kid stuff. Now, do I get to work the press, or do you get your arm permanently pleated?
I bet you were. You were trying to get in good with the screws.
Don't
do anything silly, Judy. Just take a friend and move along. No fuss, huh?
Come on, move along there.
Not bad. Where's you going to fight like that?
I had a boyfriend who was a boxer. Look, catching up on things is all very friendly, but social calls aren't really in line for you. What do you want?
Well, we figure you owe us a couple of favours.
Like what?
We need some new talent for the parlours. Wentworth seems to be the ideal recruiting office.
And I'm inside.
You must admit it's perfect.
Sorry, not interested.
Oh, I think you are. We've got contacts at Pentridge. That is where your husband is, isn't it?
You know it is. And if I don't cooperate?
Well, let's just say he could become accident prone. Let's not talk about that because it's not going to happen, is it?
Why don't you show some brains and call this damn farce off, Edwards?
Because, Mr. Spunky Screw, there's still a few things we want out of all of this.
You're not going to get a damn thing, except a longer sentence. Some hard times in solitary.
Drop the preaching. And don't get any clever ideas about the door. There's a couple of ladies out there who'd love to get their hands on you.
Ladies? Is that what they call them now?
In your position, I wouldn't call them anything else. Now, why don't you just relax and you and I can work a few things out for ourselves.
Like what?
You know, for a screw, you don't come up too badly. Loosen up a little, you might learn to like it.
Don't come that crap with me, Edwards.
Sandy.
You degrade a man, then lock him up like an animal and expect him to treat it like a pleasant social evening.
Mr. Steve Faulkner, aren't you a real gem? Your whole life is degrading people and locking them up like animals, and now you're complaining?
That's different.
Oh, sure it is. We're women.
You know what I mean.
They're just squeaky clean.
I'm not a prisoner.
And I've got news for you, boy. Now, why don't you just relax and try to pretend I'm a human being? Or maybe you'd like to try it on with a few of my friends.
Do I have a choice?
I just gave it to you.
All right. This is your party. What's next?
Guess. The bastards have broken in!
Give it up, the game's on. Let me listen.
Oh, the next one. Well, if I'd known you were coming, I'd have worn my black negligee. On your own?
No, Officer Ward's checking other cells. This isn't a social call, it's just a routine check.
You could have just checked through the spy hole, but you didn't. Oh, don't be so stuffy. There's no rule that says a screw and a con can't be friends.
I don't know how to take you, Edwards. You're in here for murder. You lead the women in a riot and I get caught in the middle of it. Now you carry on like we just met in a pub or something.
Why not? I've got nothing against screws as people. It's a system that stinks.
Why are you so down on the system? All that carry on this morning when you were guilty all along.
It wouldn't have mattered what I was. It was all rigged.
Yeah, well, I better get going.
Don't. Not yet. Sit down for a minute. I won't rape you. Cross my heart.
Is that a fact? You're after something.
Sure I am. I am human, you know. Well, maybe you just haven't noticed that. Besides, you're never going to find out unless you shut the door. See? Didn't hurt a bit, did it? Good looking.
I thought you were still asleep.
Oh, it's you. No, nobody can sleep in here with only one threadbare blanket. The place is like a bloody fridge.
It's not supposed to have all the comforts of home.
No. But some of them wouldn't hurt. Like a nice warm body to cuddle up to. Anyone ever tell you you're nice? Any other screws on duty with you?
No. Mrs. Powell's over in D Block.
It's my last night here. Better make the most of it.
Warmer now?
Uh-huh.
Got somewhere you can hide these?
Oh, you bet. Gee, times are hard for a working girl. I was worth at least a carton in the old days. Hadn't you better get back before you missed?
No rush. Mrs. Powell's the only other officer on duty. I'm not likely to run into her often.
Pity you officers don't go on strike more often.
You know, for a screw, you're not too bad.
Come in, Edwards. Take a seat. Meg, I think you'd better stay.
Sit down.
I'm afraid I've got some rather bad news for you, Edwards.
It's about my husband, isn't it? It's about Arthur.
Yes, I'm sorry.
He's dead, isn't he?
Yes, he is.
Must know that I've never tried to go against orders. Someone is setting me up. I know how word got to the police. If you can arrange a visit and get me the weapon, make sure the lagger's not around anymore to cause any trouble.
You all right?
Yeah.
I only just heard about it. I'm sorry. I didn't even know you were married.
Not many people did. No point talking about it, really. I've just been writing a letter to a friend of the family. He's the only one who can really get our affairs together. I was wondering if you'd take it out and post it for me.
There shouldn't be any problems posting it through the normal channels.
Yeah, well, let's just say I don't really trust the normal channels. If you took it out, I could be sure. It's important. It's what Arthur would have wanted. It's really the last thing I can do for him, you know?
You're all right, if it's that important.
Thanks.
You talk like you really cared about him.
I do. I did.
But...
You're wondering about us, are you? Arthur and I understood each other. If we'd been together, there would never have been anyone else. He never expected me to stop living, you know? He would have understood, see, we loved each other. We both knew that there wasn't any chance we could lead a normal life till he was out. But...
Do you really think there is a lagger?
I know it.
How will you find out? For sure.
Stoddard, I'll ask Jack what he thinks about it this afternoon.
Jack? You mean Fitzwater?
Shut up, that's not the kind of name you band around here.
You're seeing him this afternoon?
I always pay my debts one way or another. Well, we have got a lagger. Maybe she's been blabbing to Grace. It all fits in.
Who is it?
That's my business.
Don't get uppity with me.
I wasn't, Jack. But if I'm going to deal with her, then it is my business. And you know I always take care of my business.
Yes, well, I will give you that. I suppose I'll be reading a name in the newspapers anyway.
Still your part of the deal to come through.
I haven't forgotten. Still, it would be nice to know who it's for, anyway.
How are you going to get that inside? Won't they search you in here?
You leave that to me. It's my deal now.
Yes, and I must say it's a pleasure doing business with you again. Oh, Sandy.
Yes?
I'm sorry about that misunderstanding that led to Arthur's accident. Still insane not having seen him for such a long time. I don't suppose he mattered much anymore.
You know, it's a pity we've only got a few minutes left. We can have a bit of fun, just like the old days.
Arthur wasn't like a normal husband to me, Jack.
Yes, well, I sort of figured that.
He looked after me since I was 14. It's more like a father, you know, as well as the other thing. Arthur was all I had left, Jack. Oh.
You dead? Just about. Get an ambulance, will you? Well, Sandy, looks like our friend has had it. And that would be about as close to being caught in the act as I've ever seen.
It was self-defense.
Sandy, what do you take me for, an idiot?
Inspector Grace.
Look, this is murder. I've never seen such an open and shut case.
But you didn't see enough then.
Look, Fletcher, you're letting your personal feelings about this man affect your judgment.
I got here first, remember? It was all over by the time you got here.
So, what are you getting at?
Well, it's obvious that Fitzwater was trying to kill her.
He had my husband killed.
Are you sure of that?
He admitted it. To teach me a lesson because he thought I wasn't cooperating as his contact in Wentworth.
You could have gone to the police.
Before they knew. They know about others too, but they'd never be able to get enough on him for even a parking ticket.
Did you plan to kill him?
This is what she was after. It's from Bea. You don't want to see this? Good, better keep it that way. I had my suspicions, but I had no idea she'd go that far. Trading info with the cops for months. Probably the screws as well.
Well, what are you going to do?
Same as she tried on me. Listen. What I do and who I do it to is my business. That bitch is the lowest thing you can breed, and I'm going to take it out in my way, so you just butt out.
Peterson's mine, and I don't want any has-beens getting in the way. It's got nothing to do with you.
Like hell it ain't. Just who do you think you're talking to? You keep.
I've been told. Leave her alone.
Fair enough. How do you want to play this?
There's only one ace of spades in the pack, and there's only one Kate Peterson in Wentworth. Get the card, you get the doctor.
That'll do. We're going to have to wait till she gets out of the pound, though.
Just heard she's out. Must be at the second sitting for dinner.
Like your lucky day. When?
I'll let you know.
I reckon you earned that one. Just make sure you collect your winnings real soon.
Okay. Let's run through the details once more. We get Kate away from the others, and then you create a diversion, and it had better be a good one.
They're the only kind I know. You're not talking to an amateur, you know.
I didn't think I was.
Well, just you remember it. I might be in on this, but that don't make us mates, okay?
This is no time for arguments. We can sort out our differences tomorrow when our good friend Kate is 6 feet under, okay?
This is intolerable.
Oh, stop whinging. You're better off carrying the bloody bin than being inside it.
Why don't you both save your breath? I'd like to see this garbage going out this week.
You ready for our little chat, Ben?
Up to date, please, Shirley. This is probably going to be our last visit.
You're definitely leaving then?
Yep.
Ellie.
Oh, hello, Dr. Elliot.
I'm sorry to hear that.
Well, there's just no point in trying anymore. Well, unless you've got the money for a small business or a farm, it's practically impossible to get a job around here these days.
What's Steve been doing lately, Ellie?
Rabbiting, odd jobs, mostly rabbiting. It was a big decision investing in those awful ferrets of his. Anyway, he hasn't had a proper job for ages.
The employment situation's pretty bad here, I know. I'm not sure that moving's the right answer.
Well, he had a really good chance a little while back, and that councillor Muldoon killed it.
That'd be right. What happened?
Do you remember when they were extending the council chambers?
Yes.
Well, Steve's boss put in a quote for that job, and it was a really good quote. Even councillor Muldoon said so. We were so confident we'd get it, we even put down on a new ute.
Yes, and then Muldoon gave it to a big corporation.
You'd reckon they'd want to encourage local labour. Steve got laid off after that.
Our councillor moves in mysterious ways.
Anyway, he reckons we'll do better in Sydney. He's a city boy after all.
But you're not. You've lived here all your life.
Yeah.
Sorry, I was on a call to Sydney.
Oh, that's okay, Dr. Bowen. It's just Jessica's measles injection. I didn't want to have to go to a strange doctor until I absolutely had to.
Hello, and how's my favourite girl today?
Oh, what a sick dear.
Let's see what we've got inside here.
Oh, hi, Vicky. Oh, hello, Ellie.
Here you are, Ellie. Just settle it up. Send us a check when you get organised.
Oh, thanks. Look, can you say a special thanks to Dr. Bowen for us?
Sure.
He's been really kind.
Animals and small children.
It's like Mrs. Quinn was saying. How many doctors would travel so far to sit with some little kid through an operation?
Oh, hang on. He went to Sydney for a conference to hobnob it with the big-time surgeons.
Well, apparently he never even got to that conference. He sat with Robbie Quinn right through the eye operation and afterwards too. You can have faith in a doctor like that, can't you, Cheryl? Well, we'll be off. Au revoir. School French. But it's better than saying goodbye.
All the best, Ellie.
Thanks. See ya.
Bye.
How are you feeling about the move, Ellie, leaving here?
Well, Steve gave up the city life to marry me. I suppose it's fair enough that I should be prepared to do the same thing. It'll work out.
Only a pun, Ellie. Just a pun.
Yeah, well, we're taking it together. That's the important thing. If you give him trouble, he might, I don't know, warn them or something.
Oh, I'm not some big-time criminal, nothing, darling.
Well, I know that. Well, is he going to charge you with trespassing or whatever it was he said you were doing? He can't charge you, can he?
He can do what he likes. He's the law.
Oh, Steve. You don't want to go back there any more than I do you? You don't want to leave here either.
It's not a question I want, darling. We haven't got a choice, that's all.
No.
What do you want? You told me to report here. Oh, yeah, that's right. You're on private property. That's trespassing. That's an offence. I'm going to give you an official warning. Next time, I'll charge you.
Is that it?
That's it. I wasn't trespassing. I had permission to be there. I know those people. Yes, and I know you and hundreds like you. Any more back chat and you're gone. Understand that?
You're not in the city now, Nolan. If you're looking for a payoff, you're not going to get it. I can't afford it.
Who said anything about a payoff?
I know people like you too. Hundreds like you.
God, it's hot.
Get used to it. We've got a while to go yet.
Hospital at the moment.
But I love her. You can't just take her off to some home.
Mrs. Gray, it's not only a question of your employment. It's the fact the drugs were found on the premises.
But I had nothing to do with that.
And, of course, the hours you keep. I gather the child spends a great deal of her time alone.
Then I tried to find them. Did everything I could think of. Crazy things. Went around to the schools. Stopped kids in the streets.
But before that, during your relationship with Mrs. Gray, did you look after Jenny?
Yes, absolutely. Look, if Carol were to lose Jenny, if that's what the court decided, is there any way I could apply to be a guardian or to take care of her?
No, I'm afraid there isn't.
Where are they keeping her?
How's it going?
Quite well. Everyone seems very helpful.
Four? Sue and Paula said you rang them?
Right.
Yeah, well, they won't tell you anything over the phone, you know. I'd love to meet with them.
What, in a group?
No, by themselves.
Well, it's a bit difficult. I don't really have that sort of time.
Ah, here it comes, here it comes.
Hey, where's your money?
Oh, it's in my pocket.
Yeah, well, that's not where it should be, you know. You owe the kitty $9.
$9?
Oh, you're never going to pay.
Are you worried by Mr. Phillips?
He's worried by me.
Oh, how's that?
He's afraid of anyone with an opinion. He's a very frightened man. Anyway, I don't have anything he wants.
I now declare you to be husband and wife.
At the back partying.
Good, that should give us enough time.
Obviously the bomb scare didn't stop the wedding. What if the tape isn't there?
It will be. There's nowhere else she could hide it. Oh, well, Terry has come up in the world.
But so are we. I don't want her getting in our way.
Once I've got the tape, she won't be.
If she was smart,
oh, she'd that's be hard... one thing that Terry isn't.
Just as well you've got me then.
Let's get going, shall we? Are you starting there? And be thorough, aren't you?
It is in my best interest too, remember? This in the garbage bin. Cost a fortune, too.
Well, she never did appreciate all I did for her.
I do. Shame to waste this.
Yes, well, if we don't find the tapes, they might be needing it.
Well, we will.
Yes, Robert's not the most forgiving of men.
He's killed 3 men for less than what you did.
Well, they just don't appear to be here.
Well, look again.
Good. Hide.
Doing this stuff.
Oh, just as well you knew in the first place, eh? Oh, Daphne's still as beautiful as ever.
You must ask Father Barry if she's still stripping.
A cattiness doesn't become you, dear.
Neither does your philanthropy.
It pays to be charitable.
Which is why we're in this mess.
Come on. I'll go through this.
kill me. Just like this if he finds out the tape even exists.
You may have to do the same to Terry if she doesn't play. I'm not going to have you end up like Martin, so we've got to make sure, and quickly, that Robert doesn't find out.
Well, if he does, I won't be going on my own. You'll be just as dead as me.
And Terry?
I don't know who you are.
I'm Barbara Hume. I've been doing some work for Charles.
Get out!
I'm not going to hurt you, Terry. Please believe me. I've got to talk to you for your sake as well as mine.
What made you switch sides? One minute you're all over Charles, the next minute you're here telling me you want to help me.
You live with him.
Don't remind me.
Well, it's easy to get sucked in. He told me all sorts of things about you, and I believed them.
What did he say?
Oh, that you never got over being dumped by him. That you'd do anything to get back at him. That you'd destroy him if you could.
Did you believe that?
I did. I believed everything he told me.
I didn't.
You did once.
You had me fooled for a while, but I've learned a lot since then. You must think I'm really stupid. This is just another way of breaking down my guard, isn't it?
Somebody must have believed you when you said you wanted to get out.
What made you change your mind about him?
Lucy. She trusted me and I was using her. I really want to get out, Terry. And I think I need your help.
Please, please. Hello? I wish to report a murder. A Mr. Charles Durham. No, I didn't kill him.
Something about him.
Con?
You want to talk about it?
Yes. Well, something.
We'll do that tomorrow. And this? Tomorrow.
Might take me a couple of weeks, but, it'll be all right.
Take your time, Rolly. Happy?
Haven't been able to sleep.
Good. You're happy.
You too, doll. Thanks for coffee. Lunch?
Uh-uh.
Oh, it'll sell all right. That's not my point.
No, but we agreed at the meeting, Sam.
Printing cost will go way up on this one, Con.
And those proofs. Well, we could go over the figures again.
Yes, let's do it.
Tomorrow?
Yes, of course. First thing, then? Well, good night, girls.
I wish he would just go away quietly somewhere and count his money.
Here comes Mrs. Stinson.
Don't tell them I'm up here.
Huh?
Don't say a word.
Are you here all by yourself, Aku?
No, I'm just playing football.
Where is he?
He's flying kite.
Well, if you need us, we're just going down to the other end of the park, okay?
Ring a ladder.
Hmm.
Mum and Turbo.
I'm not really stuck. I don't need a ladder.
Safe and sound.
All right, easy does it.
That's the funny place to be flying a kite for.
Thanks, Mum. Thanks, Turbo.
Don't thank us, thank Aku. She's the one who called us to the rescue.
Yeah, lucky for you she was around. You could have been stuck up there all night.
Thanks.